Very well run. Johnny Rhodes is in, but he's home. Torfall's asking for the replay. It's going to be very close. He looks a bit disappointed. Gilchrist, in fact, I think he may be walking.
Well, that's in the air. This will be caught. It's gone straight up. Rhodes says it's mine. Yes, leave it to me. Gotcha.
It was quite special for me against Australia. You know, one of the two best sides in the world. And I'm quite happy with myself. I did well against them. And I was quite nervous in the beginning. And, I'm happy. I'm happy with myself.
Well, that's in the air as well. Is this going to... No, it's not. It's going to be caught. Yes, it's out. What a wicket that is. Tanner Marcus is having a wonderful night. Oh, good shot. Johnny Rhodes can't get to it.
That's poor bowling.
He's charging and what a great hit, but it's going to go a long way. He just bounces a metre inside the rope. Oh, great shot.
Straight down the ground. That'll be four. Racing away to the fence. What a magnificent straight hit.
They played fantastically well. Very difficult to bowl to two guys when they're in, especially at the death. I think we've got to give them credit and say they played fantastically well and outplayed us on the day.
You're sort of just hoping that something goes your way, but it wasn't swinging. We didn't have Nicky Boyer as the variation. But I knew we needed to get the breakthrough, and when it wasn't coming, we were staring 290 down the barrel.
Cut shot. Brilliantly played. Absolutely magnificently played. Teller Marcus, you see the look on his face.
After the first two wickets, we're in with a chance. And they played out of their socks.
That's it. That's a century. It's a great century as well. Back for the second. It may even hit the fence. What an unbelievable knock this has been. Came in with the chips down. Michael Bevan, as is so often the case, has played a superb knock.
Whether it's been technically or mentally, I think it's just happened for me in one day cricket. And I've been lucky enough to be good at that form of the game without probably having to stretch, I guess, my potential.
That's it, they're going. Wonderful cricket. A century to Steve Waugh as well. A faster century once more. Well, they're getting their legs stretched here in Melbourne. On their feet they are again, in a matter of balls.
So to be hitting, hits it well, that's through cover. It's off the mark and it's going to be four. Good shot, wafted away, that's another boundary. It's well played by Gary Kirsten, good over for South Africa.
Oh, in the air, through the gap on the offside, that's four, that's much better. We need some runs here for South Africa.
He's gone, he's got the edge, Harvey gets the first wicket with an out swinger.
Yeah, I think you've got to watch him very closely, but the lighting in the stadium wasn't that great, so it was difficult to pick up the change of pace. But you had to sort of bat against him a while and receive one or two of his slower balls. You know, obviously they've worked very hard in their variation, which has become part and parcel of one-day cricket these days. A whole lot of them are of a fine bowling aside, and you've got to work hard against them.
Wrong and from Shane Warne, and well picked by Kirsten.
Well, there we go, and he's out stumped. That's nicely bowled, beautifully bowled Shane Warne. And very well done too by Gilchrist. We smashed that through the offside. Take that.
It's a great shot. It's a glorious shot. Harvey got him. Went for the full shot. Wasn't short enough.
Owen, was there a bit of bat? No, he's giving him a LBW. Oh, he plays that often, the reverse sweep, he's hit that one away down over the top of backward points head, not quite off the middle. Well, that's in the air, and the bowler won't mind this one, it's got him, so he's gone for the shot again.
Bowled him, that's a good comeback by Shane Warne. He went for the York, he gave himself some width to hit it through the upside. Single to Kuzner, that's a big win for the Australians. They really have dominated here at Colonial Stadium. It's been a very professional performance. Good shot, just a fraction short. It's right away beautifully through mid-wicket.
More big appeal there, and he's given him out. That's out, LBW.
Chance at mid-on, and he's gone. Darryl Cullinan managed to hole out at mid-on.
Bowled him, he went to charge and he was straight, he took middle and off stump. Gillespie strikes, it's well bowled.
That's going to be at the infield. That's well played. That's the area we were talking about, all the way for four. Lovely cover drive.
Well, in a way, beautifully. That's probably the shot of the match so far. Good hit. It's a long hit. Straight, and it's six. That's beautifully struck.
That's the 54, Jonty Rhodes.
Gone again. And his man out there should be caught. He's gone.
And that's his 50. That's very well played. Boucher came out there when they were in a spot of bother and needs to continue from here. In the air, got him. Bokdyken, good catch. Firmly struck. Shane Warne was in the way. That went like a rocket to him. Was it that in the air? This is this going to get caught as well? I think so. Yes, taken. Very nicely taken. He's as cool as a cucumber in the outfield.
Nicely played. It's Gilchrist's strength. Give him some width, he puts it away.
We try to hit the lens every time, tuck him up. And, you know, if you give him width, he'll hit you over the top, he'll hit you in the gaps. And you have to have discipline against him.
Oh, Marcus, far too short.
Beautiful shot. That's more like the Adam Gilchrist we know.
That's where he's got a bowl, but he puts him away because it was too full. That's beautifully driven. You've got a strong offside field. You've got to be angling the ball across the left hand, but it was a genuine half volley, and Gilchrist took full toll.
Well, that's a lovely shot. That was a Mark Waugh special. Gilchrist has now passed 3,000 runs in one-day international cricket.
Oh, and that's beaten everybody. And what's more, it's gone to the boundary for four. That's frustrating.
I think the finals is pretty well played from Connie.
Oh, he's hit that one in the air. There's a fieldsman coming around. This could be out. Yes, he's taken it. That's very well taken. Paul in the deep came around a long way there. And, well, he caught it in his fingertips, only inches above the ground.
If you don't vary it too much, the batter will line you up and try and score boundaries off your bowling. And if you vary it with your pace and the lines that you bowl from, it could go your way.
Well. Oh, he's bowled him. He's bowled him. Hang on. Who knows? He could be about to see a hat-trick here or some such thing, because that's what is needed. Bowled him. Clean bowled him. Oh, he's hit that beautifully. That's a magnificent shot. That's all the way. That's six. That gives you some idea of how strong he is.
Oh, that's close. That's a big one. Lance Klusener gets through him. Times is knocked over, and all of a sudden the gate's just a little bit open. Harvey goes with the man. He should catch this. He should. He does. That's a big wicket. Klusener picks up Harvey. My word. 32 off 26. He gets a pass, a man at fine leg. Square leg's coming around, he won't get, that's a boundary they need it. That's not great bowling, just went down leg side. 22 or 14. That's hit over the top, that'll be six, that's going, going, going. That's a beautiful shot. Got the refraction short, my word, what a cricketer he is. Four and then six, Pollock just a fraction short. The perfect pull shot. Bevan swinging a miss, got it! He's got an edge! That's a wicket, swinging over mid-wicket, Bevan. Boucher takes a good catch, all struck. Anybody's ball game?
I didn't know he was such a good bowler and such a good wicket-keeper. I believe he was a wicket-keeper in his younger days, and he's a good player.
If he doesn't bat, he bowls, and if he doesn't bowl, he keeps.
He's backed himself as a death bowler, and he showed us in the nets that he can produce the right sort of delivery. So we backed him, and he did the job for us.
Shane Warne, it's bowled in! Oh, what a wicket! What a wicket for Andrew Hall! And now it is anybody's ball game. He tried to hoik him over mid-wicket, he went for the boundary. Hall kept it straight. The Australian skipper is clean bowled. 13 off 6. Get back, South Africa. There's four of them. That's beautifully played. Hey, he's a good hitter. That can make a big difference. It was a good shot too.
I should have defended that. I would like to think at 9 times out of 10 I'd defend 13 in the last over. But they got off to a good start. The first ball of the over managed to hit it for 4, which is difficult to come back from. Obviously you're trying to bowl Yorkers and things came off the pad, luck didn't go our way.
He's straight down leg side, that's beautifully played.
4 runs off 3 balls. You've got to think they're favourites now, Bill.
Captain's got to do something special. He got him out surely. He's got in, yes he has, but Warne's on strike. That's the key, Gillespie's gone. It's 4. Is it 4? It's 2. Oh dear. He can't quite get it right, can he?
Those sort of situations that get tight, it's pretty nail-biting stuff.
I was sort of quite relaxed. I was just looking to bowl it as full and straight as I could and hoping that he would hit it straight to a fielder.
And he comes, the last delivery. It's a tie.
But maybe Pigeon should have been down there to slog a 6 maybe, who knows.
Yeah, very disappointed, you know. We were out of it up until about the 40th over or so, and then we really fought back and should have gone away and won it. But it was an exciting game, great to watch. But that doesn't really do much for the morale or the feeling once you've tied the game, especially when you think you should have won it.
Gone, very well caught. That was flying quickly. Out. It must have been a faint edge, and he's been given out by umpire Hare. Oh, right through him with pace. So Darryl Cullinan was out there quickly, but he's departing just as quickly. Chance, Mark Waugh again. South Africa deep in trouble as the fourth wicket goes down. A bit more catching practice there for Mark Waugh.
Well bowled, well played, very well played.
The guys really fought back, 19 for 4, we could have written us off. And there's a partnership which was required at that stage, very vital time. They saw off the new ball, it was still new when they got in, and scored at a good rate and managed to set a bit of a grounding where we could come in and play off it. So their partnership was very important.
That's well played. He's managed to get a bit of bat on that one.
Great shot. When he's in touch, he can play all the shots. Ask the question, he's got him! He's out caught behind, maybe off a glove. It was a quick delivery, it was at his body, Kuznet must have gloved it. Umpire Hare had no hesitation at all. That's the end of a good innings, but a big wicket.
It's well played, very well played. Right up on his toes, and he's hit that one through the offside field. Oh, that's a good shot. Very good shot. Short outside off stump. Pollock that time. Oh, great shot. Beautifully driven through the offside. Where's this guy been?
Charge him. He's hitting very straight. It could be 6. It's a good clean hit. It is a long way back. That's the biggest hit we've seen here at Colonial Stadium.
Yeah, it's almost premeditated. You know, he had both mid-on and mid-off up, and I decided I'm going to go down, and if it's there, I'm going to have a full go at it, and, well, it worked for me.
Waited for it. That's 6. That's a long way gone. That's, boy, yeah, hitting it over the fence again. He picked the slower ball. That's good cricket.
Oh, well, that shot I still can't believe. It's not my type of play, but coming in on the death, you know, you've got to try a couple of things and hopefully a middle one or two to hit a couple of sixes.
It's got a hold of it. Could go for 6. It's going. Here comes Bevan. Knocks it back. They'll get 3. In fact, they'll get 2. So after 50 overs, it's 7 for 206.
Oh, good shot. Beautifully played. Straight down the ground. Oh, he's hit that one. Will it go all the way? Not quite. Oh!
In the air inside. Beautifully played. That's his strength. Down the ground. Crack. That's 4. Too much width. Beautifully played.
Nice, beautiful shot. And that brings up the 50 for Adam Gilchrist. That's hit very well. Too short from Callis. Oh, I thought that was going straight to mid-off.
Well, that's in the air. This could be out. It has to be out. Someone's called for it. Yes, and that's it. Ntini has got a very important wicket here. Now, all of a sudden, we've got two new batsmen at the crease. Could it just be that South Africa can make it difficult again for Australia?
No ball. He's hit away almost for six. It could go. No, it bounces to experienced cricketers. This could be out. It is. This time he's hit straight to mid-off. That's a big wicket.
Oh, this will be out if he hits. Oh, he's got him. I think that's out. I think that's out. There was a stutter down the far end. No doubt about that. Had there been commitment in the first instance, he would have been okay. In the air, and this could be out. Kirsten's a good catcher. He's taken it.
It was awesome getting it there, and especially against a side like Australia. A couple of things worked for me. There were some very good catches from our guys, and there was a couple of wickets for me. So it's nice to know if when the ball goes in the air that somebody could be under it to catch it.
There's a chance. It's a man. It should be caught. He will be caught. That's good bowling. I'm sure it was intelligent batting. Boyer in his last over has really opened this game. Bowled him. Telemarcus knocks over Damian Martin. That is a big wicket. It's well hit. It's four. Bad delivery. He's hit straight through the line. Big Jason Gillespie keeps Australia's hopes alive. He hit a six. He can hit it high. There's a man coming around to catch it. It's Kirsten. He's normally good. He's very, very good. He takes the catch. That's the end of Gillespie catching under pressure. The South Africans doing a great job. There it goes down to third man. So what a wonderful series. It's ended in a tie. Australia 9 for 198 after the 48 overs that was allotted. A jubilant South African captain. The Super Challenge ends in a tie.
I really enjoyed it. I thought it was a new concept. It was a nice idea. It certainly works, especially in winter when you do have a lot of rain around.
Although it's a very, very nice stadium, a great stadium, I don't think it's suitable for cricket. The light's a little bit low, and also the underfoot conditions are a bit wet, so it could get quite dangerous in the field.
It was pretty cold in that stadium. I don't know if that can change.
It's about 19, I think, degrees outside and about 10 inside the stadium, 9 degrees in the second one.
The facilities were quite good, actually. The lights were good. The wicket was good. The ground was a little bit muddy. That was because they'd just played football on it, so it was perhaps not the best time to play on it. But apart from that, I thought it went really well.
Just a nice new concept.